How to make YouTube thumbnails in Canva. In this tutorial, we're going to show you exactly step by step how we create our YouTube thumbnails using our amazing tool, Canva. To get started, head over to canva.com and select YouTube thumbnails so we get the right dimensions. Then you can choose a template that you want to start with. We're going to use this Getting Around New York template because I like the overlay on the background and I like the corner edges with the color. Let's change our main heading. We're going to start off with how to, so type in how to, and then what I want us to do is ungroup these subheadings. So if you drag over all three and you click ungroup, then we can grab these individual subheadings and just move them down to the bottom so they're out the way for now. And then we're going to drag our main heading up and we're going to duplicate it. Now it's up to you whether you want to do one heading in one text box or if you want to do it separate like I'm doing it. The reason why you would do it separately like this is if you want different words to be different sizes, it's a lot easier to do if they are all separate. But I think for this example we're going to do all of them in one text box just to make it nice and easy and keep it as a simplified thumbnail. So we're going to change it to how to make YouTube channel. Now with your text in your thumbnails, it doesn't have to be exactly the same as the title of your video, but it needs to be the right kind of keywords that people will be searching for. So you want them to search and then see the text in your thumbnail as part of their search. So most people are going to be trying to find out how to create a YouTube channel or make a YouTube channel. And that is the message we want to send off with our YouTube thumbnail, which is like a billboard for your video. So it's really important to make sure you create good thumbnails. But you already knew that because you're spending the time to watch this video and learn how to make great YouTube thumbnails. Let's head over to Elements and I want to grab a YouTube play button. So I want to put one of these play buttons in the bottom right. Then let's grab another play button and drop it in the top left. We're going to resize this so it fits nicely. And try and get these aligned and the sizes the same. So what I'm going to do is delete the bottom right one and then select the top left and just copy so that it is exactly the same size. And then I'm going to select these corners and I'm going to change it to the YouTube red. So these corners are going to then match. It's really important to make sure that we do match these colors and they fit in with a consistent theme on our YouTube thumbnail. So let's just adjust the text so it fits nicely. You want the text to be as big as possible so it's easy to read on small devices such as mobile phones, but not too big that it takes up too much room. So just adding in that A balances our text quite nicely. And then let's head up and let's choose a nice text theme. So I like to change the text because then it makes your thumbnail feel unique. Make sure that you choose a font that fits with your channel theme and your brand theme. If you have a font already that you use for all of your items on your YouTube channel, then change the font to that text. For now, we're just going to keep a nice, bold, solid looking font. With us increasing the text and changing the font, we're going to have to now make these play buttons a tiny bit smaller and adjust them so they fit nicely in the bottom corner and then line with the top layer. So we're going to delete that top left one like we did last time, copy so we have the same size, and then put it into the top left. The last thing that I want to do is change this background picture. So you can search in photos and have a look if they do have any nice free photos that you want to use. You can pop one of those in. But if they don't have one that you are looking for or that suits exactly what you want to use, you can head over to unsplash.com and check out. They have some really cool images. So I've uploaded a few photos from Unsplash here and let's see which of these is going to work nicely and fit with our YouTube theme. So that one won't. That's quite a nice blurry background, so it doesn't take away too much, but it's got quite a nice feel. So let's drop it in there. Because it's portrait, it's not going to fit correctly. So we just need to double click on that. These background images can mess you around sometimes, but if you double click in the right area, then you can get it to come up like this, and that's what you want it to look like, so that you can adjust the size and move it around. So let's try again with that double click and see if it'll come into the area where we can edit. There we go, that's what we're looking for. We might need to zoom out a bit so we can see the entire image, and then just make it a bit bigger so it fits right across our thumbnail. And then you can drag and adjust so it fits exactly where you want it to on your background. And then click done once, and we've had that looks really nice. I'm very chuffed with that. Zoom back in to check you're happy with it. And our other YouTube disappeared there. So let's just copy that again and then drag it across so it's symmetrical. Now remember, you don't have to follow this tutorial step by step. It's just to show you and give you an idea to get those creative juices flowing. You must make your thumbnails unique and how you want them to look. Once you are finished and happy with your design, we can head up to the top right of your screen and click on that download button, and you have a thumbnail ready to upload to YouTube. If you're new here and you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. We create new videos every single day. Before you go, have a look at our other Canva tutorials, and we hope you enjoy them.